Welcome to blog number 49, and this is me learning to play this instrument, which is the melodeon. The tune that I'm sharing with you today is something that I started to write a couple of years ago. Initially I just called it French Tune, because it reminded me of those 1960s black and white French films, or films set in Paris. And I've been to Paris a few times. It's a city I really love, and it really reminds me about strolling down the Seine on a summer's day. You can't beat it, it's absolutely lovely. If you haven't done it, I recommend it. So I call this piece Boulevard Saint-Michel, which is a street in Paris, which is kind of near the Seine, near the Sorbonne. Boulevard Saint-Michel is mentioned in a favourite song of mine by Peter Sarsted called Where Do You Go To My Lovely, which was a hit back in the 60s. And it had a very nice accordion part in it as well. Anyway, I'm going to show you how I play this and talk about it a bit, so I hope you find it interesting. You'll need a three row instrument to play this. I'm using an ADG. This row is A, this row is D, this row is G. That's the keys that those rows are in. And it's got an A part and a B part. If you haven't already done so, I recommend you downloading the music from my website, and the address is on your screen now. You will see that the A part is in the key of E minor and the B part is in the key of G major. I mean, essentially it's the same key, it's one sharp. There are two versions of the music for you to download. One's got the note names written above the notes, which might help you, and one hasn't. Obviously putting the note names in kind of clutters the page up a bit, so I've given you the two options. So let's just talk about the way I write my music out. It's a little bit strange. It's a bit confusing as to which row you use to find the note. So basically, any note that has a square head to it is found on this row, the A row. Any note that has a diamond-shaped head is found on this row, which is the D row. And any note that has that kind of normal, kind of egg-shaped head to it is found on this row, which is the G row. And you will see that during the course of this piece, you're going to use all three rows. So you can see that the first bar, it says E minor, that's the left hand chord, we'll deal with that in a moment, and it says pull, so you're pulling the bellows out at this point. It's 3-4, so it's three beats, typical waltz, typical 1-2-3, 1-2-3, pa-pa kind of thing. And as I say, the first three notes are B, E, G. Now, I do this in a quite a weird way. I've been learning to play the chromatic button accordion as well, which is a sort of a different beast. And on that instrument, you do tend to use your thumb quite a bit with the right hand. And I'm finding on this tune that I'm using my thumb. It's quite unconventional. Most people that play the melodeon don't use the thumb on the right hand, but I am on this tune. So when I play that B, that first note, which is on this instrument, it's the second button down on the A row. I'm using my thumb on that. That's got a square head, that note, so it's on the A row. And then you've got three notes in a row on the D row, so they've all got diamond heads. and they are E, G, B. So you're basically running up through an E minor chord there. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and the third beat of the second bar is the note C. It's got a conventional head on it because it's found on the G row. So timing there is 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you've got three crotchets, 1, 2, 3. Then you've got a minim, which is two beats, that B note there. And then the third beat of that bar is a crotchet, that C on the G row. So you basically go from one B up to another B, all on the pull. Then you're pushing in as you come back for the A note on the D row, and it's a dotted minim tied to a dotted minim. That means you're going to play it and count six. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, or two lots of three, two bars. It's held for two bars. So, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's your first four bars. Now, the next section has got the same timing, but obviously it has different notes. I'm starting on the D row, and this note here is an A, octave below the note I've just played, and I'm using my index finger on it. And the next note is D sharp, which is found on the first button on the A row. It's an accidental. So it's quite weird, isn't it? Although you're sort of going down, the note is higher because it's an accidental. It's kind of a weird note, just stuck on the end of the instrument there. And I use my thumb on that. You don't have to, but I tend to. Then you jump up to F sharp. So notice the A has a diamond head. D sharp has a square head, and the F sharp a diamond head again because you're back onto the D row, and then up to the top A. So again, you're going from one A up to another A. Okay, and then you've got the B on the G row. Okay, normal head of course, and then back to G on the D row, diamond head. So let's have a listen to those first eight bars. Pulling out to start with. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So you can hear the timing's the same, but the notes change, and you've got that dotted minim tied to dotted minim in both sections. So then you have this. G, B, A, G. So the G is on the D row, diamond head, as is the B. The A is on the G row, so normal head, and back to G on the D row. That's still pulling, and then you play exactly the same buttons, but pushing, you get F sharp, A, G, F sharp. So pulling, G, B, A, G, pushing, F sharp, A, G, F sharp. So that's the beauty of the melodeon, the fact that you get two notes per button. Same notes again, still pushing. There's a different left hand chord behind that, but we'll get to that in a moment. So you've got and then we're going to run up. Now to finish off the A part, and it's only called the A part because there are two parts to the tune, the A part and the B part. You could call it part one and part two if you like. So this is the end of the A part. And you're running up. And what I do here is, as you can hear, I overlap the notes. I play the first button there, which is an E. Keep that ringing while I play the G. Keep that ringing while I play the B. Keep that ringing while I play the C sharp. So there are four buttons all in a row. But I cut that pretty short. So the notes are E, G, B, C sharp. And as I've said on the music, the overall effect is of an E minor sixth. That, play it all together, that's an E minor sixth. An E minor with an added C sharp, if you like. And then I cut that pretty short, and there's an E minor chord behind that. So let's play section A, just the right hand. After three, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And what I've tried to get here is that kind of Parisian effect, that kind of French accordion effect. There are some incredible accordion players in France and, of course, right across Europe. All I've done here is try to sort of dumb it down a little bit, provide myself with something I can play that gives me that flavour without it being sort of too hard. And if you're not a very experienced player like me, you might find this quite nice to play. It's fairly slow, it's fairly relaxing. So section A is 16 bars and that gets repeated. Now let's have a look at the B part, and essentially it's the same key. It's all the Fs are sharpened. And by the way, if you have notes that aren't Fs that are sharpened, they are accidentals. And incidentally, because you can see that D sharp and the C sharp, you know you're in a minor key, because in the key of E minor, you very often get the C sharp and the D sharp. So the section B part, if you like, a key of G major, it's got a sort of more majorish feel. It starts on the G major chord, and we have this. So notice this has the same timing. I've kept that theme of the timing, even if I've changed the notes. So I've got these notes, F sharp on the D row, diamond head, and then a whole load of notes on the G row, or with normal heads. G, D, B, G, and then A pulling. Timing wise, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Okay, now what we're going to do now is we're going to keep depressing that button. We're going to press that same button again on the G row. It was giving me an A on the pull. If I push it, it gives me a G. And if I play this note here, which is an E on the A row, I've got a nice two-part harmony there. So what I have here is this two-part harmony. I have an E note on the A row and a G note on the G row. Play those together and you get a nice harmony. Once you put it in the left hand, of course, it really sounds very interesting. Now I'm going to play the same two buttons, pulling out, and that gives me another harmony. This time I've got an F sharp on the A row and an A note on the G row. So I've gone from E and G to F sharp and A. And they're both dotted minims, so they fill the bar. So 1, 2, 3, 3 beats on each. Little two-part harmony. So now I'm going to do a nice little staccato two-part harmony. The lower note is an F sharp, which was, remember, we played on the A row just now. Now we're going to play it on the D row, but pushing. And to go with that, I have a B note on the G row. So those two buttons, and see the little dots underneath the first four sets of F sharps and Bs. Keep the notes short and detached. When you get into the next bar and you're playing the F sharp and the B, of course you hold it for three beats. So let's play from the beginning of the B part. So same again. Now this time we push in and we play two notes on the G row. The lower note is a G, the upper note is a B. Nice two-part harmony, pushing. Now we keep. So we play the G and the B, and then we play them again, because what's going to happen, we're going to play a different left hand to give us a different chord, a different overall chord. And then it says D, C, al fine, or fine if you like, da capo from the beginning down to when it says fine, finish, which is at the end of the A part. So basically you play the A part twice, the B part once, and then the A part again once. When you get to the end of the A part, when you're actually finishing the tune, I tend to go slow it right down, have that lovely sustaining E minor sixth chord. It's worth saying that if you learn this on an ADG and you've got another three row, like a GCF, all you've got to do is play the same buttons and it will magically transpose it into D minor and into F. I don't think it's possible to play this tune on a two row, but I haven't really tried. For me, I find it nice and easy on this three row, and I wrote it on this, actually I wrote it on my Roland Electronic FR18 Melodeon, and if you look back through my videos you'll find an early incarnation of it that I'd just written the A part. Anyway, let's sort out the left hand. You only need the bottom group of buttons, the kind of normal set of eight buttons that you'd find on a two row box. I do this one finger per button thing, so anything on the row nearest the floor, I use my little finger, then my third finger, then my second finger, then my first finger. And obviously that changes a little bit as we have to do a bit of cross rowing. But anyway, it starts with E minor. Typical pa pa. So I use my middle finger on the E bass and my index finger on the E minor chord. That's pulling. Now if I play the same buttons pushing, it gives me a B note and a B major chord. So E minor pulling, B major pushing, and back to E minor pulling. So I start off with E minor pulling for two bars. I have four bars of B major pushing and then two bars of E minor pulling. So E minor to start with, B major, and E minor. Then I have one of these cross row chords, which is rather lovely, A minor seventh. If you look on the sheet, it tells you that A minor seventh is a C major with an A bass note. So I'm using my third finger on the C major chord, which is on the inside row, and I'm using my first finger on the A bass note, which is on the outside row. Okay, and then I'm going to just come up one button each row, same fingers, but pushing in. That gives me a B minor seventh, which I need, and that is a D major with a B bass. So A minor seventh, pulling, B minor seventh, pushing. And you notice those chords have got little asterisks on them, little stars on them, because here what we're going to do is we're going to do this. Play the bass note and the chord together and sustain it, get a nice warm sound. And now what I do is I come over and I play B major. So I keep the B bass, but I add a B major chord to the B bass. So I have just a normal B root note and B major chord together. Pull out for E minor. So the last part of the A part is all sustained chords. So let's just play that A part, just left hand only. E minor sixth is building up there. Now I have a little bit of a problem with my playing because I'm still fairly nervous on this, even though I've been playing for well over 3 years. I still get a bit nervous when I play it, and what I tend to do is I tend to shave a little bit of timing off each bar as I anticipate the next chord change or the next note in the next bar. So I do, so I can show you what I do. Sometimes I do this. know what I did there? Jumped to that next bar too quickly. Instead of... I'll be so careful that. And if you listen back to my old videos, I do that an awful lot and I cringe every time I hear myself doing it. So I'm trying to correct that. So not... a nervous habit of mine which I'm trying to correct. So anyway, that's the A part and it goes twice. Let's count you in. 1, 2, 3. Did it there, see? 1, 2, 3. Need to bring your hand up so that you don't foul or play notes on the A row. So it's all a matter of relaxing. Now the B part, left hand, like I mentioned earlier, this is basically in the key of G major. Starts on a G major chord, and the G major chord, the bass note is the one nearest the floor on the outside row. And the G major chord, because the one above that. I use my little finger on the bass note, and my third finger on the G major chord. So I've got pushing in, G major. Now, what follows is an A minor seventh chord, this time not sustained, but actually broken up into bass note and two chords. So I tend to use my index finger on the A bass, which is on the outside row, and my second finger on the C chord, which is on the inside row. So it is an A minor seventh chord, broken up into bass note and chord. So obviously a C major chord with an A bass note gives you A minor seventh. So it starts off with G major, A minor seventh. If you play the same buttons that you used for the A minor seventh chord, but you push them instead of pulling them, you get a C with a D bass. There's your C, and there's your D bass. So you had C with an A bass, and C with a D bass. Don't forget, this button gives you C major in both directions. And then you go back to G major. So let's have a listen to what we've got. To D major there. Rather nice, isn't it? Yeah. Nice harmony, isn't it? And then what I do here, G major chords go this, and the overall effect is a G major seventh. Weird the end there, isn't it? There you've got G major chord sustained, and then I play the same right hand notes, the G and the B. Instead of playing a G major chord with them, I play a B major chord with them. Let's see if I can explain this to you. I'm playing a G and a B together in both bars. The first time, pretty straightforward, G major chord with it, so essentially still G major. But then I change my left hand to a B major, and by playing those two notes with the left hand, along with the left hand I should say, the overall effect is a B augmented fifth, because that G is the fifth of the B major scale raised up a semitone, which gives us B augmented fifth. That may not interest you, it may, who knows. It's quite an unusual sound, and I came across that by accident, just by messing around as you do when you're composing, and I thought it sounded really nice. And then you're back into your A part. So let's play the B part all the way through, both hands.
So a lovely sort of sweeping feel to it. And again, I was being very, very careful there not to shave those bits off the ends of the bars. Yeah, it's worth mentioning once more that the left hand, E minor and B major are on the same buttons. If you pull these buttons, it's E minor. Push them, it's B major. You also got A minor 7th, C with a D bass, I mentioned that earlier, on the same buttons. And also G and D are on the same buttons. Obviously, different bellow directions give you the change. On the end of the piece, I play these notes. And I also sustain the C sharp as well, and with the E minor chord in the left hand. I do that sort of dramatic dip in volume and a little nudge on the bellows. Gives us that classic accordion ending, doesn't it? So there we are. Like I've said at the top of the page, play this piece in the spirit of a 1960s black and white French film. If you're as old as me, that might mean something to you. If you're not, then perhaps it won't. But I hope you enjoy playing it. I've enjoyed writing it. I've enjoyed doing this video for you today. As I say, you can get the music from my website. I'll see you soon.